Hey guys, I finally need to make this last clip. My voice is still croaky and I may sniff every now and again. Deal with it. Okay. We are looking at simplifying exponential expressions, and it is really a tough topic, and it's early in the year and it discourages a lot of students. So let me give you a few examples, hoping that with a few examples it's going to clear things up. One thing, however, is that though it's helpful to learn from examples, it is a very wrong method to learn mathematics. Because once you get to university level, you need to understand and know theory. And it makes the world much easier when you understand theory. So before I get into this, let's just revise our theory quickly. When bases are the same, I can add exponents. Okay. If I multiply, if bases are the same and I'm dividing, then I can subtract exponents. Then, when I have a base that has an exponent, and that whole expression has an exponent itself, then I can multiply those exponents. And then another one that is extremely important is that when I have a base that is the product of two things or more, and that base has an exponent, then that exponent gets distributed or multiplied to each base inside to its exponent. In other words, a to the power of n times b to the power of n. Now this one goes both ways. Well, all of them goes both ways. I can go in that direction as well. In other words, I can write this again as the product of two factors. So if I go in the opposite direction, I'm factorizing. Same with this one. Okay. And this one, it's not very often used in the opposite direction. But of course you can use it in the opposite direction. It's an equal sign, it goes both ways. This one, very important. When my bases are the same, different. But my exponents are the same, then I can multiply the bases and keep the exponent. Let me give one example of that. For example, if I put 2 to the power of 3 times 3 to the power of 3, I can get 6 to the power of 3. Okay, very important word. Take note of it. Okay, so how do I address these types of questions? Oh, I've got another one there. You want to go to your cup. Deal with you right now. Okay, how do we address these types of questions? Well, first of all, we need to determine whether it's got terms at all. Are there pluses and minuses in the numerator or in the denominator? If it is termless, then you're going to prime the bases. In other words, make sure all of the bases are prime numbers. And then secondly, we're going to use our laws to simplify. Okay, so here we go. Let's first prime our bases, which means 16 can be written as 2 to the power of 4. Okay, for time's sake, I'm gonna do it. Okay, 8 is gonna be 2 to the power of 3. But now, 8 has got an exponent. So I must give 8 its exponent. Okay. Now, 8 is just written as 2 to the power of 3. It still has the whole 8 has that exponent. 4 can be written as 2 sweet. Okay, but 4 has an exponent. 8 plus 1. And then the last one is already. As a problem. So now we can see, now we use our laws. And the law that seems to be very much applied here is this. You see that? 2 to the power of 3. To the power of 8. In other words, I multiply exponents. So 2 to the power of 4 times 2 to the power of 3. Divided by 2 to the power. Now here is a very tricky one. 2 is multiplied with n plus 1, not just with n, but with n plus 1, so I keep it in a bracket, times 2 to the power of n plus 4. Nice. Next, I see, now I get to use my first law. Then the bases are the same, I can add exponents. I've got two bases that's the same. Here they go, 2 2's in the denominator as well. So I've got 2 to the power of 4 plus 3 in the denominator. I'm also multiplying 2 2's. So I've got 2 to the power of 2, which is distributed, plus 2 plus n minus 4 plus 4. And now I see I've got two bases that are that divide each other. Okay, so I'm going to take the numerator, which is 2, which is 4, plus 3n, and here comes in the point where you've done everything correct, and you do the one, this 1 from 1. Subtract the whole base. So put it in brackets. Guys, listen to me. Put it in brackets, not in your brain. But let's just simplify it anyway, it's going to be easier. 2n plus n gives me 3n. 2 and 4 gives me 6. And now we see a very nice answer, because the 3n and that 3n subtracts from each other. So that's 0. 4 minus 6 gives me negative 2, 2 to the power negative 2. That's fine, you can leave it like that. Or you can say 1 is being divided by 2 because the exponent is negative 2 times. So 1 divided by 2 divided by 2 gives me 1 divided by 4. In your face. Not you. I'm talking about the question.